first speaker of the evening is an award-winning geologist and best-selling author of Rocks, Ridges, and Rivers, Geological Wonders of Banff, Yoho, and Jasper National Parks. So, given that, it probably doesn't surprise you that the Rocky Mountains are in his passion. Please welcome Dale Leckie.
There's a great choice of scenic sites in our Rocky Mountain parks. What you see in front of you is Crowfoot Mountain, and in front of it is a lake. Then we're looking at rocks that are 300-400 million years old. And we're looking at a lake right in front of it that's water. Those rocks are wearing down. And you can see debris flows, alluvial fans in front of them. You've got such a great choice of scenery in the Rocky Mountains. There are rugged mountain peaks, ice fields and glaciers, alpine meadows, lakes, waterfalls, extensive karst cave systems, and deeply incised canyons. Enjoy that scenery. That's Hilda Peak, just at the north end of Banff National Park. So I identified 50 spectacular sites to visit in Banff, Yoho, and Jasper National Parks. And I can't tell you about them all today, so I'm going to tell you, or I'm going to make a choice of some of my favorites. And all of those sites are along the highway. Sometimes there's some hikes, but it's not always about hiking. And so, from the road, you can easily see them. So your first choice is to go to Yoho National Park. And one of the things you'll see there is that those majestic mountains are wearing away. Mountain building has come to an end. There are precipitous cliffs, rock falls, talus and debris flows wearing those mountains down. And that is Cathedral Mountain that you see. Now, you might be worried about going there, and your choice is it dangerous to go to these eroding mountains? Here's Mount Stephen, and the erosion of the mountains creates natural hazards. You can see the debris flow chute coming straight down onto the Trans-Canada Highway, straight down onto the Canadian Pacific Railroad. Is it dangerous? Nah, I'd say go there and visit it. Make a choice to visit Mount Parkway Lookout, Mount Banff. There are mountain ranges you can see that are stacked and shingled, just like shingles on your roof. Think of the tremendous forces required to create that landscape. And in the last 60 million years, 7 kilometers of rocks have been eroded from the tops of those mountains. It's pretty amazing. Go to Medicine Lake in Jasper. It's ever-changing. And your choice here is in what season should I visit? Should I go in the spring or summer when the lake level is high? Or should I go in the autumn or winter when the lake level is low? Did you know that Medicine Lake drains from its bottom just like your bathtub? So here's Medicine Lake, a map of it, and you can see two words there. It says sink, slime sink, and main sink. Those are cave entrances. That's where the lake drains. It says Moline River. Well, very rarely does water ever flow in Moline River out of that lake. So here's a line going from Medicine Lake to Moline Canyon. And you can see drawings of those caves. It's 16 kilometers to Moline Canyon, where you can see the springs coming out. Those caves are 100,000 to millions of years old. The caves have a diameter of 11 to 15 meters. The choice is, should I do the 7 kilometer long Moline Canyon hike? Go to Mount Edith Cabell, and you can see that recently glaciated terrain. The glaciers came down those mountains, and off to the right, where you can see the words Little Ice Age Moraine. The choice is, should I do the steep 8 kilometer Cabell Meadows Trail? But what about the grizzly bears? River erosion creates chasms and great circular potholes. And that's what you see there. And in my mind, sometimes there is no choice. Just go and see these sites. And speaking of grizzlies, the word Mistaya, and this is Mistaya Canyon, Mistaya River, is Stony Dakota for grizzly bear. Did you know that the Earth nearly froze solid once, thawed, and then froze solid again, right to the equator? And there was during a period called the Cryogenian. And cryo is Greek for icy cold. Your choice here is, do I believe this or not? Did you know also that the moon was once closer to the Earth? As a result, we had much more powerful tidal currents. That moved the sand around, and there was up to 1 kilometer of sand deposited 500 million years ago. And so your choice is, where should I go to see these rocks? Lake Louise, Mount Edith Cabell, Yoho National Park. Your choice on this one is, should I go see the 500 million year old edge of North America? in Yoho National Park. That yellow dot was the edge of North America. Now it's at 2,800 meters above sea level. In the lower figure, those dots show where sea level was and where that upper yellow dot is. This used to be the edge of North America 500 million years ago. Your choice, be sure to go and see it. And so on the left side of the slide, Cathedral Formation. That's the edge of North America. In front of it is the Stephen Formation. Again, the edge of North America. I think that's pretty amazing. Shrinking ice fields, the Columbia Ice Field and the Athabasca Glacier. The bottom of the slide, you see the words or the number 2000. Well, that's the year 2000. That's where the glacier was in 2000. In the last 100 years, 20% of the Columbia Ice Field has decreased in size. What choices can I make to reduce this, if possible? This is what the rocks look like where the glacier was 50 to 100 years ago. You can see little ridges pushed out every year when that was happening. You can see big boulders, stones, that they were on the ice and within the ice. And lateral moraine, those words, were a pile of dirt on the side of that glacier not very long ago. Jasper Lake and sand dunes. Well, Jasper Lake is just outside of Jasper, and the Athabasca River flows through here. In the winter and late fall, the water level of Jasper Lake falls. The wind blows from the west and makes sand dunes. The choice is where to best see this lake and the dunes. So this is what Western Canada looked like over time. It was south of the equator. It was warm. It was nearly frozen solid. The moon was closer and closer, and great volumes of sand were moved around. There were tropical reefs, and then it got very hot and dry. Your choice is there is no choice. That's the way it happened. So geology creates spectacular mountain scenery in the Canadian Rocky Mountain Parks. You have a choice of where to go to see that scenery, and I'd like to help you with the book, Rocks, Ridges, and Rivers, Geological Wonders of Banff, Yoho, and Jasper National Parks. Thank you very much for your time.